Call it the other Bennington, not the quaint hamlet in Vermont, but the hard-working village in New Hampshire. This Bennington distinguishes itself with modesty and longevity. The paper mill here for 200 years.
How's it going there, little buddy?
The restaurant going on 75 years. And the nearby inn owned by the same couple for nearly a half century. Outdoor enthusiasts might know it best as the home of the Crotchet Mountain Ski Resort, which has roots going back to 1964. Today,
we hit two really big targets. We hit the families, and then we also hit the college students.
That's because the mountain is open from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m., and on Friday and Saturday, they stay open until 3 o'clock in the morning.
We have everything from easy trails all the way to black diamonds, and we also have some glades in here. We're focusing a lot on our parks this season, which is awesome. Everything from progressive parks to the bigger parks where people are really hitting the jumps.
Marketing and events manager Megan Myhaver grew up in Bennington and on these slopes. She says proximity to Boston makes Crotchet an easy day trip for families, and
it's small enough that you can come with a big group of people and you don't all have to stay together because you're fearing of getting lost, but it's still big enough that you can go and do all kinds of stuff all day long and not get bored.
Joe Kademi never gets bored either at the eponymous restaurant his father started in 1945, Alberto's, a modest, family-oriented Italian eatery. Joe was making circuit boards when he was laid off and came home to work with his dad.
Of course, it gets a little contentious working with your father. It's his way. But you learn a lot about the business, both sides.
That was 50 years ago. Over those years, Joe has made it his own, adding new dishes as times and tastes have changed.
I wanted to broaden it out, so I got into more fish, haddock scallops, and we make our own chowder. Everything prepared on site and all by hand.
Situated next to the dams on the Contacook River, the restaurant's tagline, "Best food by a dam site," has also endured. These days, Joe leaves the kitchen mostly to his chef of 30 years, and he, a former town selectman, serves as mayor of the restaurant.
How you guys doing over here?
Joe thinks his father would be proud of the restaurant's success.
I think it's just a combination of the food, the people, I'll include myself along with that, and the customers that we have.
See you later there, pal.
Just down the river from Alberto's, the last vestige of a once thriving mill town, the still thriving Monadnock Paper Mill, the oldest continuously operating paper mill in the country, celebrating 200 years in 2019.
We make a lot of wallpaper. We do a lot of very specialized packaging for the medical industry. We make the base for sandpapers. The scent strips that you get at the fragrance counter, which is highly engineered to make sure it mimics the human skin, the pH, so that you're not changing the scent. So it's a pretty interesting science creating all these different papers.
They also generate 50% of their power needs from the river, which drives giant turbines that help run the machinery. Wood pulp is sourced from elsewhere, so there are not the smells or environmental concerns of some paper mills. In fact, their environmental stewardship has been praised. It's important to the Verney family, which bought the mill in the 40s and who live on the property.
They wanted a healthy place to live for themselves and their in the community. They're sportsmen, they fish, they hunt, they appreciate the environment and felt that they needed to be stewards of the property that they had acquired.
And this summer they will be throwing parties and welcoming tours to celebrate the mill's bicentennial.
So we'd like to share the joy and the accomplishment with as many people as we can. I think it's quite a feat to manufacture in New Hampshire for 200 years.
It's also quite a feat to own and operate an inn here for 45 years.
We were hoping that when we graduate, we'll be operating some big hotel in a big city, but somehow we just landed around here in a small inn.
It's a good life to be.
John and Rose Perry have done that at the Inn at Crotchet Mountain, located just across the Bennington border in Francistown, a mere half mile from the ski resort. Bound by a shared love of skiing and backgrounds in hotel management, they have succeeded in a business that sees a fair amount of turnover.
We do a lot ourselves. I do all the cooking, chef. John take care of the front, and we have great staff. Life is good. Everybody get along.
46 years of marriage, 45 years as business partners. The Perrys are now ready to enjoy life beyond the inn. It's for sale. A little over $1 million for the inn and 63 acres of land.
Obviously, we love the spot and it's been great for us. And we kept putting off making that decision to put it on the market. It's just that, you know, there's things that we'd like to do, travel and visit friends that we haven't seen in a while. It's just time to move on.
And we move on as well from the good people and the good feelings of the other Bennington.